Hey, my name is Nibzscape and welcome to my new series. In this series, we're going to be attempting to kill every boss in Oldschool Runescape from scratch. We'll be starting with absolutely zero GP in the bank, and we're going to be working our way up to killing some of the most difficultest bosses in the game. The rules are simple. I can only kill a maximum of 10 of each boss. Plus, if I want to wield a unique from said boss, I have to have killed it already 10 times. So, for example, if I wanted to wield a Bandos Godsword or a Bandos Chestplate, I must have already killed General Grador 10 times. With my PVM abilities, this is definitely going to be a massive challenge. Welcome to my journey. If you want to watch the full series, I've put a link on the screen now to the playlist. Also, I'm going to link the playlist in the description below. So, yeah, check it out if you want to watch it from episode 1. This episode, we're going to be heading back to probably my least favourite place in the whole game. And that is the wilderness. We're going to be taking on another 3 bosses, starting with Venonatus, a dangerous spider that at any moment can finish me off. And also we're going to have to watch out for PK'ers because, you know, the wilderness and all of that. I'm sure it'll go absolutely fine, so let's see how this goes. So, episode 6, and we're heading back to the wieldy. I know in the last episode I said, I'm not doing it, I'm not going back to the wieldy. The PK'ing incident was not fun. But I really want to get him out of the way. It's going to be a lot of fun. I've never killed any of these, so it's definitely going to be very, very shaky. But I'm sure it'll be fine. The only thing I am a bit worried about is a couple weeks ago, the achievement diaries came out. Well, not the achievement diaries, the combat diaries. So, obviously, that means there's a lot of people probably going to be in the wieldy killing some of these bosses to get some of those achievements done. Now, there's probably a lot of PK'ers that know this, and they're probably going to be camping these areas. So it is a little bit risky still, but I want to try it. We'll see how it goes. I mean, if we get this first couple in and there's way too many PK'ers and it's becoming an issue, maybe we'll stop. But if it is a little bit quiet, we'll carry on doing it. We'll just see how it goes. But let's get in with our first boss. So for the first boss, we're going to be taking on Venonatus, which I've had a little look at a quick guide just to see how we're doing this, and we're going to try and use the safe spotting method. We're going to grab ourselves some range items, so we're going to grab ourselves a magic shortbow. I do actually have an imbued one in my bank, so what we'll do is we'll buy this and then we'll swap this out for obviously the imbued version when we go out to do it. So armor wise, honestly, I'm thinking of just going for black dehide. I mean, I think it got nerfed the other day and it's not quite as good as the Blessed Dehide, but I really don't want to risk too much money in the wieldy, especially at the moment, because there's probably going to be a fair few PKs. I am expecting to see quite a few, so I'm going to go for the Black Dehide. We will buy ourselves some decent boots, so we're going to get ourselves, probably the cheapest is probably going to be the Bandos, 200-odd-k, we'll buy them. We will buy ourselves a Glory Amulet. We'll buy ourselves a Blessed Dehide Coif. And to be fair, I'll probably just use my Rune Gloves, which are in my bank. And another good item, probably worth getting from the bank, is our Arva's Assembler. So we're going to grab that. And then the only other thing we're going to need is some Amethyst Arrows. I'm just going to grab myself about 200 should be enough. And then we're just going to grab ourselves a load of supplies. So we're going to grab ourselves an Antidote, Stamina Potion, 2 ranging potions, a few Saradomin brews, a load of super restores, and then we're just going to grab ourselves some manta rays. And teleport wise, I'm thinking of just grabbing myself a burning amulet and a royal sea pod as well, just to get out of there. And then I just filled up the rest of the slots with a couple prayer potions. I think we're looking pretty good. Obviously, let's have a little look, see how much we lose if we die. But there we go. If we die, we lose 236k. Which is definitely not fun. We should have an item protected, so that does drop down to 189. It should be fine. We should be absolutely fine. Okay, so tiles are marked for the safe spot. Venonatus is over there, sort of slowly coming to the area. Oh, he's going to aggro me because he's coming too close, I think. Oh, is that the right tiles I've marked there? I think they are. Oh, can you piss off? Oh, right, that's definitely not safe spotted. Holy shit. Yeah, definitely not safe spotted again. Definitely took a big fucking cheeky hit. Ow, I'm getting absolutely destroyed here. Okay, so I have got it safe spotted. Not quite the way I wanted it to be, because, yeah, we are in multi at the moment, but, I mean, it's safe spotted. I'll definitely take that. We're just gonna slowly kill him. Should be fine. Okay, so there we go. First Fenonatus kill down, and 200 blood runes. Not too bad. Alright, so there we go. Not too bad, not too bad. Oh shit. Alright, we definitely set that one up wrong again. What a pain in the ass, what a pain in the ass. Right, I'm taking auto retaliate off as well, because that's definitely not fun.
2 hours later.
Oh, okay, so we do have one kill on Venonatus, but honestly, not enjoying it. Not enjoying it one little bit. Do I give up on it? There was another PK'er as well, which is one of the reasons I ran off then. Super annoying, because this is the first time I've got to a boss, and I, not that I can't do it, it's just super, super frustrating to get into that safe spot, and I can't quite, I ain't got the hang of it yet. Maybe I need to watch some more guides or something. I don't know, but I've been doing this now for quite a long time, so we'll go on to another boss, I think, because that's probably the best bet. So for our next boss, we're going to be taking on the Chaos Fanatic, a boss relatively similar to the Crazy Archaeologist, a couple special attacks we have to watch out for. Overall, a relatively easy boss, but there are a few decent rewards, so we might get lucky. Now this is a very, very easy boss. Very similar to the, is it the Chaos Elemental or whatever I done back along? Remove some of your stuff, so we're going to be using like Summer Pies and all of that fun stuff. Divine Ranger Potion, I've got 3 doses. I might just pick up one more of them, and then we're going to pick up a load of Summer Pies, and then that should be us done pretty well, to be honest. So, Chaos Fanatic, we're going to be going with this range setup again, so not too much has changed. Obviously, Summer Pies, I brought an extra potion. I mean, we should be pretty good with this. Maybe I should pick up an extra stamina potion to run away, but I think we should be fine. We should be absolutely fine. Let's telly. I think I want to go to the lava maze, and hopefully there's no PKers. 41 wilderness. Oh, do you know what? Yeah, that's annoying, because I haven't got a teleport out of there. I suppose I have got the glory, but hopefully we should be alright anyway. I think it's protect from mage, so let's run into this. Let's get some kills in. Let's get these 10 kills. This is 10 kills I should be able to get, so yeah, fingers crossed, should be alright. And there we go. That is kill number one coming in, and we get some monkfish, which is absolutely useless. We're not even going to pick that up. Kill number two coming in. Beautiful, beautiful stuff. Monkfish again. Oh man, we are getting super unlucky with these drops. And that is kill number three coming in. You've got to be joking me. Monkfish again. You hate to see it. You really hate to see it. But 7 more to go. Hopefully we get some better drops, because if I see monkfish one more time, I don't know what's going on this episode, but I'm definitely not having a good time here. And there we go. Kill number four coming in, and shark. A bloody shark. You have got to be joking. And there we go. That is kill number five. And Wines of Zamorak. Finally, something. That pretty much covers the cost of one of our prayer potions. But at least it's finally a drop we can actually take back and sell. I'm going to say this, and I'm going to end up coming across a PK in a minute, and I'm going to lose this as well. But fingers crossed, we'll be all right. Kill number six. And uncut sapphire. Wow. That's all I can say about that, really. Wow. And there we go. That is kill number seven. And let's turn off my prayers a sec. There we go. Some, at least another drop, another 5k drop. Not the best, but once again, we'll take that, because I've been getting a lot of shit, and that's I'll definitely take that. And there we go. Oh my god. Pure essence. So that was kill number eight, and we got pure essence. So that was kill number nine, and we get some uncut sapphires, emeralds in noted form. So that's actually quite a good one. We'll definitely take that. And there we go. That is the final kill, and split bark body. That is actually quite nice to see, because that's 26k. Wow. This is absolutely crazy how bad the loot was. I honestly think we probably made quite a loss there, to be fair. So the total made from the Chaos Fanatic was probably around about roughly 45k profit. Probably didn't make a profit. By the time we take out the Amethyst Arrows, by the time we take out obviously all the supplies, the prayer potions, draining through the prayer potions, the kills were very, very slow. I probably had the wrong gear. That was pretty naff. Let's get back to the GE though and sell some of our stuff. For our next boss, we're going to be taking on Vettian. Another boss that I've never done before, and I have no idea how well this is going to go, because they haven't gone good so far. But I think the best method for this is melee. I mean, we do have enough for the Vigora's Chain Mace, but we are investing pretty much our whole cash stack into that one item, which I think is just going to... It's just a little bit too much money, and I don't really want to put that much money into it. Now, I think one of the best ways to kill this is with the Verax, which obviously we used in the last episode for a few of the bosses. I think that is probably going to be the way to go. So what we'll do is we'll buy a full Verax set. Now, the only other items which is worth buying, obviously we've still got the Rune Gloves. We might as well buy ourselves some more climbing boots. Obviously we have the Mythical Cape, so we might as well grab one of them. But that is pretty much everything we need. So now it's just a case of getting some supplies. We might as well sell that Divine and Ranging Potion and pick up a combat. But other than that, we are pretty good. So to get the Vetti on, we're probably just going to use the Corporal Beast Teleport. I think that's one of the fastest ways to get there. Other than that, we are pretty much all set. I might just get myself a one-click teleport to get out of there. I think that's probably going to be a safe thing to do. Walk a little bit this way. And there we go. Beautiful stuff. Easy, easy stuff. And then it's just a case of, oh, maybe not. All right, maybe that did not go quite the plan. Okay, second time, a little bit lucky. Now we've got him set up quite nicely. We are getting attacked by the Chaos Dwarf, but we're not taking any damage whatsoever from Vettian. So, beautiful, beautiful stuff. Obviously, now we just sit here and wail on him until he dies. I forgot that we got to deal with these hellhounds, but again, we can just wail on these until these two things die. Accidentally fucking unsafe spotted him, but he's so close to being dead, I'm just going to fucking tank this, I think. Oh my god, if I protect from melee, he can still absolutely smash me, apparently. But there we go, he is now dead. 45k worth of Ultra Compost. We'll definitely take that. I mean, it's better than absolutely nothing. Let's finish off this Chaos Druid though, because that's super annoying. And there we go, kill number two. Uncut diamonds, uncut rubies. Not too bad at all. And there we go, that is kill number three and a rune two-hander. I mean, that's another 40k, so it's not quite a dragon two-hander, but we'll definitely have that one. And there we go, kill number four, and we get 400 Chaos runes, 17-odd-k. We'll have that. That ain't too bad. And kill number five coming in, and 18k coins. A little bit naff. And this should be kill number six coming in. I'm fingers crossed we get the Ring of the Gods, because that would set this account up massively. Come on. Can we get that last hit in? There we go. Super restores and a load of dark crabs. I mean, that does kind of set me up to do another trip. And that is kill number seven coming in. We get 50-odd-k worth of death runes. Not too bad. Okay, some PK'ers. PK'ers. I'm getting absolutely destroyed here. Keep moving, keep moving, keep moving. Well, I hope they enjoy their 300 fucking runes. There we go. That is kill number eight. And oh, I saw pickaxe. But unfortunately, it's just a rune one. Another lot of PK'ers. Luckily, I managed to sort of get away this time. Oh, for fuck's sake. More fucking PK'ers. Lovely. Of course. Of course. And I'm probably going to die any second now. Oh my god. Oh my god, I got smited as well. Seriously. Seriously. I think that's the third time I've been PK'd now. And it's multi, so as soon as a clan show up, I'm just fucked. Oh yes. Come on, come on. Just... Oh, I've ruined a safe spot, but please tell me I can just finish him off. Please tell him I can just finish him off and we're going to get out of it. Oh shit, alright, we're going to take a big hit in a minute. Oh shit. Okay, we're good, we're good, we're good. And we get a load of dark crabs. And super restores, an absolutely pretty much a worthless one. But nonetheless, we will take it. We'll kill these. I think we're going to stay here for one extra trip just because of that. Oh, I didn't even get that on record, but I got fucking absolutely destroyed. Absolutely destroyed. All for absolutely nothing, but I did get fucking smited and I lost everything. Fuck's sake. Oh, that's another... I've literally lost probably about 300k doing this. And this whole episode has been an absolute disaster. Okay, I am literally going in the most minimalistic setup ever now, where we're not going to lose absolutely anything. We're the same lot of PK'ers again, and I've actually managed to get out of it. I did use all my food, but they're fighting among themselves now. Some other PK'ers showed up. Such a nightmare. And, okay. Oh, I was PK'd again. This time I literally had nothing in my inventory, and it was kind of done me a favour, if anything, because it gets me back here. I've been trying to get this now for the last half hour, 30 minutes, and I'm just getting PK'd every single time. There, I can see, like, all these scouts just hopping from world to world, and then they're tagging me and freezing me and killing me every single time. So, I think we are going to skip that last kill for now. We'll come back maybe at a later date or something. We'll see how I feel. For our next and final boss, we're going to be heading to the deepest parts of the wildie to take on Scorpia, a deadly scorpion out to kill me if the PKers don't beat him to it first. If I see a PKer, I'm going to lose my shit. Okay, so for Scorpia. This should be fun. Hopefully we don't get PK'd. The loot is absolutely trash, even the two like shards of the ward or whatever. They're pretty cheap. They're only like 100 odd K if we get super lucky. The average loot, I think, is only worth 9K. So, absolutely trash loot. I'm not going to be bringing any decent gear, that's for sure. We'll stick with a couple of items, which we'll obviously keep. So for our first item we're going to get, it's going to be the Trident. And we'll give ourselves around about 200 charges. I think that should be more than enough. We're also going to pick ourselves up an occult necklace, then just some monk robes. We'll grab ourselves out a book of darkness out of the bank. We're going to buy ourselves some blighted ancient ice axe. I think this allows me to use the freeze and stuff. So if we buy ourselves... Oh god, they're expensive, aren't they? 100 of them for now. That hopefully should be more than enough. And then the only other items we're going to buy, a little bit of food, a little bit of prayer potions. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Oh, and a couple antidotes just so we don't get absolutely destroyed. If we die, we are losing 200 odd K. If I do die and I do get PK'd, I'm probably just going to quit this episode while I'm... I like to say while I'm ahead, but I'm really not. I've lost so much money being PK'd. It actually makes me pretty sad. But we needed to get these bosses out of the way, even if we do lose a bit of money. Fuck's sake, I completely forgot to even change my spellbook. I went all the way to my house and I completely forgot to change my spellbook. Oh, I'm actually having an absolute meltdown today. Fuck my life. Okay, so I think this is pretty easy. I think when he gets to around about half health, he spawns some minion thing. So we just freeze them and then kill him. So they should be spawning around about now. There we go. So ice barrage them. Move him over here. Ice barrage him. And then we carry on killing him, and then that's it, I think. And there we go. That is our first Scorpio kill down. And Guaimi Quams. That is Scorpio kill number 2. And 3k coins. Probably just about covers costs. But yeah, 2 in the bag. 8 more to go. And there we go. That is Scorpio kill number 3 coming in. 3k coins. And there we go, that is Scorpio kill number 4 and a rune pickaxe. 20k, that's actually not too bad, we'll take that. And that is Scorpio kill number 5. Oh, better put my prayers back on, otherwise I'm going to get smashed. But Admiral Pies, I mean, it's going to heal me up a little bit, so we'll take that. And there we go, that is kill number 6. And we get a few prayer potions, we'll definitely take them. Or just one prayer potion, that's pretty naff, to be honest. And that is kill number 7 coming in. And a rune sword. And that is kill number 8. I am running severely low on charges. 35 charges. Hopefully that's enough for one more kill. That bucket of sands, that's a pretty naff drop, to be honest. But we'll have to take that one. Okay, so that is kill number 9 and super anti-poison. What a load of crap. And there we go, that is the last kill. Super anti-poisons again. Very, very naff. Let's get the hell out of here. Let's hope we don't come across any PKs now because we'll literally lose everything we've just gained. Okay, so there we go. Safety at last. Okay, so the loot tracker on this one says we made a grand total of 54k. So, minus obviously all the costs of the ice sacks, obviously, yeah, all the runes. We probably made a loss, which is a little bit gutting, but that is another one crossed off, which is very good. Do you know what I've just realised? I've used the obsidian ward in a previous episode, and I shouldn't have used it until now. I keep messing up on this series. That's the second time now, because obviously I've messed up big on the episode 2. I ended up using the dragon pickaxe to do Zolcano, and obviously I hadn't killed any of the worldly bosses at all at that point. So, yeah, I keep messing up the series. I suppose technically the obsidian ward isn't really a unique as such. It's just the pieces are uniques that go together. Maybe it's okay, but nonetheless, we have killed most of the wieldy bosses now. Bar one, Vetion, and the spider one, whichever one he's called, which is super, super annoying to kill. I'm going to sell all my stuff now, and I'm going to give myself one more go at Vetion. If I get PK'd, I'm not going to ever bother again, but we'll see how well we can do. It's not all over because a PK'er can show up at any second and kill me. I've got him down this far so many times before getting killed by PK'ers. We better get the Ring of the Gods to make this all worth it. Or at least a Dragon Pickaxe, because if not, we've had an absolutely awful, awful episode. If we can actually finally get this last hit off, there we go. Please, please, please. 40-odd K. What a disaster of an episode. We've lost. I reckon I've lost probably about 400, 500k this episode total. Oh, that is gutting. That is absolutely gutting. But what can you do? What can you do? At least we've got 10 kills of Vetion, 10 kills of Scorpia, and of course the Chaos Fanatic. So that is pretty much all of the wieldy bosses done. Bar Venonatus, which honestly I'm probably not gonna go back to until pretty much near the very end, because I really couldn't get the hang of it. There is one other one, the King Black Dragon, but he's not really a wieldy boss. I mean, you have to go in a wieldy to get to him, but I'm not too worried about that one, and we will definitely be doing the King Black Dragon. But other than the King Black Dragon, which we will be doing at some point, that is all the wieldy bosses done and dusted for quite a while. So there we go. That ends the episode. That's the cash stack. We started with around about just over 9 mil this episode, and we're down to 8.5. It's been a bad episode, I'm not gonna lie. It's been a very, very bad episode. At least we have got some of those wieldy bosses out of the way. Hopefully, next episode, we're gonna see some more. Hopefully see some more profit at least, because, yeah, I can't take another episode like that, because that was absolutely dreadful. I hate the wieldy. I really, really hate the wieldy. The bosses are trash. The loot is trash. PK is killing me every 5 seconds. It's super annoying. But there we go. That is pretty much the wieldy finished off. I hope you guys enjoyed the video more than I enjoyed making this one, because this was, not exactly the funnest thing for me. But I hope you guys enjoyed it anyway. And if you did, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. It helps the channel out massively. And you guys are awesome. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.